The Chief Magistrate's Court at Buganda Road, presided over by Gradon Magistrate Julia Basajavalaba, has today granted cash bail of 100,000 shillings and non-cash of 300,000 shillings to the 19 suspects who were arrested during demonstrations on Tuesday last week.
The worship bail is premised on Article 28(3)(a) of the Constitution. We have substantial surety.
The accused have been on remand in Luzira Prison since then on charges of causing common nuisance. A team of lawyers led by Bernard Owundo, the president of the Uganda Law Society, who offered free legal services to the protesters, ensured that they were granted bail.
So today, about 19 people have been brought to court for mention. And as the Uganda Law Society, we took the opportunity to apply for bail for the 19 accused people who have been accused of breaching the right to protest and charged with the crime of common nuisance.
Over 100 protesters have been on remand, according to Owundo, and they will appear before the court in batches.
Yeah, so in total, we have about 100 people who are arrested. I think the police has said about 105. We have about 105 people who have been arrested. Most of those people are going to appear in court on different dates.
He said the Uganda Law Society is committed to offering free legal services to all the accused. The suspects are expected to return to court on August 29th for hearing of their case. Fire broke out early today in Luzira, Nakawa Municipality, leaving residential and commercial structures destroyed. It is suspected that an electrical short circuit is the cause of the fire, which destroyed a number of property. The police fire brigade was called to stop the fire from spreading into the neighborhood. After the fire was dimmed, some residents were seen trying to salvage what they could at daybreak. Authorities cautioned residents against illegal power connections, citing the dangers it poses to the community. Stakeholders from education and health sectors are calling for a sexuality education policy amid rising sexual immorality among youth, evidenced by increased teenage pregnancies and young parenthood. This was revealed by officials of Hope Mbale during a meeting at Royal Suites Bogolobi in Kampala. They highlighted the urgent need to reinstate sexuality education in and out of schools to curb the increasing moral decay. Miriam Muhaye, the Mbale District Woman Member of Parliament, noted that detrimental practices in the Wamasaba culture have significantly impacted the youth, leading to higher rates of young parenthood and school dropouts. She emphasized the need for culture leaders to engage with the youth to foster behavioral change.
The challenge of teenage pregnancy, defilement, is at a higher rate in the Elgon sub-region, but specifically Bugisu sub-region, because of a number of reasons. One being poverty, the second being our culture.
Officials from the Ministry of Education and Sports say that the government is revising the sexuality education policy. They also highlighted the critical role of senior men and women teachers in the school setting.
We are also fast-tracking the approval of what we call the National School Health Policy. You have heard it, the what? Mm-hmm. Well, because they realize that, okay, maybe that's why, and part of, by the way, the interventions within the policy, we have issues of sexual reproductive health, where sexuality comes in. But that right now, honorable, our policy now is at cabinet, my honorable minister.
Strengthening the clubs at school, there is a lot to do with, of course, supported by the patrons that are teachers, to which we occasionally train, the senior women, senior men teachers.
The re-establishment of the sexuality education policy is a crucial step in addressing the escalating issue of teenage pregnancies and promoting healthier lifestyles among the youth.